Hi, this is Yolanda Vanveen from vanveenbulbs.com, and in this segment we're going to talk about how do flowering plants disperse their embryos. Well, it sounds kind of complicated, but it really isn't, and it's not that different from humans or other animals. The females all have eggs, and when they have bear their fruit, after that they have little seeds, and then the seeds produce the babies. So they need fertilized. So with plants, most plants are asexual. They don't need a boy to fertilize them. They can fertilize themselves. So they have the male and female parts within themselves. So the flower goes to bloom, then produces a seed pod. And within that seed pod is an embryo, and that's a baby for the next year. So an embryo is the inside of a seed. So the seed you set, what you see is actually the seed wall. So a seed is kind of like a chicken egg. There's an egg inside. And on the outside is the whites, and that is what gives the baby the nutrition. And on the inside of that is the actual seed. Here on the Sagapanthus, this is a seed pod. But within that seed pod, there's even smaller seeds. And within the smaller seeds, there's actually an embryo. So even within the smaller seed, there's a covering. And so when that's in the ground, it falls onto the ground in the fall, and then naturally it'll come up and it'll start growing in the heat of April or May. And so genetically it's programmed, it knows it's a certain heat and a certain moisture. The seed covering will kind of break apart and the embryo will begin growing. So the seed covering is actually protecting the embryo. And so they disperse in many ways. Birds will eat the seeds and then they'll take them to other places. The wind will blow the seeds around. Animals will rub up against the plants and the seeds will get onto their fur and then they'll go into other areas that way. So seeds can disperse in many, many different ways. But the most important part of the seed is the embryo, because that is what produces the next plant for the next year.